We're going to learn the workflow for level prototyping and finalization for Godot 4. This will teach you how to go from the prototype phase in Godot and then replacing your prototype with finished models using Blender. And it's easier than ever now with Godot's new Blender support. And if you wanna see more tutorials, hit that subscribe button. So let's start with setting up the path for Blender to Godot. So for this, you'll have to be using Blender 3.0 or later. So let's go to Project, Project Settings, and search for Blender. You might have to enable Advanced Settings for this if it's not showing up for you. And enable Blender. Now press Save and Restart. Now when it's restarted, go to Editor, Editor Settings, and search for Blender again, and under the file system import, this may already be automatically set up for you, but if it's not, you locate it and it should be inside of the Blender Foundation folder and select the version you are using. Now I'll show you how to quickly prototype levels in Godot. So let's start with adding a CSG combiner node to our scene. This works as a container and also allows you to do Boolean operations. Move the combiner to the location you want in your scene, and also make sure to enable use collision, otherwise your player will just fall right through it. Next, add a CSG box as a child to your combiner and scale it up to the size you want by dragging out these points. And if you can't see them, you have gizmos turned off and you can enable them in perspective. Now duplicate your box by pressing Ctrl D. Now there are three Boolean operations. Union fuses intersecting meshes into a new mesh. Next, intersection. This makes it so the only thing you can see is the parts that's intersecting. And lastly, the most useful one, subtraction. This subtracts from the other mesh. Now I will show you how to make a grid texture and the process of applying it to your meshes for a better sense of scale. And I also recommend having your player close by for even better sense of scale. Now go to the top link in the description and we'll make a grid texture. Right here, go to the preset tab. I like the valve preset the most, so that's what I'm gonna choose. And now you can select the color RGB you want. I would love for there to be a way to enter your color code, but sadly you can't. When you're happy with your color, you can click here to save and drag the texture into Godot. Now back in Godot, drag your grid texture onto the material tab and scroll down to UV1, enable triplanar and world triplanar. If you don't wanna do this every single time, you can save it by hitting the drop down arrow next to the material and hitting save. Now I'm gonna be making a water mill prototype, and I'm gonna use the cylinder shape and holding Ctrl while rotating it until it's at a 90 degree angle and scaling it up to the size I want. And now we're done with the prototype. I like to keep the prototype really simple to save time. Now we're going to export this into Blender. And what I like to do is copy everything that you want to export and paste it in a new scene. And also make sure the position is zero. And the reason we did this is because the way Godot exports is that it exports the entire scene. Now let's export the scene. Go to Scene, Export As, GLTF 2.0. Now we open up Blender, and let's start by deleting everything by pressing A, X, and Delete. And now we can import our GLTF file from Godot, so let's go to File, Import, GLTF 2.0, and locate the path to the Godot project, and open up the GLTF file. And what I like to do is to put everything we imported into a new collection, and name it something like reference or just ref, so you can toggle it on and off when you work with it. And also make a new collection folder for the model. Here's a time lapse of me making the model and trying to keep it similar size and shape to the prototype. Now when the final model is finished, delete your reference or rename it to -noimp. And combine everything in your final model by pressing Ctrl+J. And also make sure to apply all your modifiers and transforms before you combine it. You could just give it a name now and -col at the end, and that way Godot will detect the -col and automatically make a collision for it. But what I recommend is that you recreate the final model with simple shapes. This is both better for performance and for collision. Now combine everything in the new collision model we made and name it -col-only. And it will only import the collision and not the mesh. And what I also like to do for the finished model is to set origin to geometry up in object, set origin, origin to geometry. One more bonus tip, sometimes by accident you get double vertices, and to fix that, go into edit mode, select everything and hit M and merge by distance, and that will remove all the double vertices. All the suffix names are down in the description, and you might want to use different ones for your needs. Now we can save it, and make sure you save it inside of your Godot project and where you want to save it, and it will automatically show up in Godot. And now if you want to make any changes, you can easily just go to Blender and make the changes, save, and it will automatically update in Godot. And if you have any questions, leave them down below. And I'm also working on a game, so make sure you wishlist it. And also you're in my Discord server, why not?